Hi, Dr. Drake. Let's go for a ride to the park and talk.
Sounds like a great plan. What's our topic today, Garrick?
Emergency medicine, heart to trauma care. Explain.
Perfect! Let's do this.
Shall we sit on the bench?
Absolutely.
Welcome to our channel, where we delve into the intricacies of medical emergencies and the science behind them. I'm Dr. Garrick Pattenden, and with me today is Dr. Ashton Drake, as we unpack the pathophysiology of diseases and their acute management. Today, we're focusing on the critical aspects of emergency care, from cardiac events to trauma response.
It's a pleasure to be here, Garrick. Let's start with cardiac emergencies. When we talk about acute myocardial infarction, or heart attacks, we're dealing with a time-sensitive condition where early intervention can mean the difference between life and death.
That's right, Ashton. The heart is a muscle that requires a constant supply of oxygen-rich blood. When a coronary artery is blocked, parts of the heart muscle begin to die. This is where the concept of time as muscle comes into play. We use medications like aspirin and nitroglycerin to manage the patient's condition on the way to the hospital.
And upon arrival, we assess for reperfusion strategies, which may include thrombolytic therapy or an emergency coronary angiography. But let's not forget the importance of post-infarction care, including lifestyle modification and cardiac rehabilitation.
Absolutely! Now, transitioning to cerebrovascular accidents, or strokes, we categorize them into ischemic and hemorrhagic. For ischemic strokes, which are the most common, rapid restoration of blood flow is the priority, using thrombolytics, within a narrow window of time.
And with hemorrhagic strokes, the approach is indeed different. We focus on controlling bleeding and reducing pressure in the brain. Surgery may be necessary to alleviate this pressure and prevent further damage.
Let's also touch on respiratory emergencies, like asthma and COPD exacerbations. Asthma attacks can be terrifying for patients, and rapid administration of bronchodilators and steroids is key to reversing airway constriction.
In the case of COPD exacerbations, oxygen therapy and ventilator support might be required. These conditions highlight the importance of emergency preparedness and the ability to respond to a patient's changing needs swiftly.
And speaking of swift changes, anaphylaxis is another emergency that can escalate quickly. Beyond epinephrine, we monitor airway patency and prepare for possible intubation if there's significant swelling or respiratory compromise.
Trauma is another vast area we encounter in emergency medicine. From motor vehicle accidents to falls, the initial assessment follows the A, B, C, D, E approach: airway, breathing, circulation, disability, and exposure. E also stands for environment and extrication. Garrick, could you elaborate on the trauma management protocol?
Certainly. Trauma patients require a systematic evaluation to identify all injuries. For instance, in cases of blunt abdominal trauma, we're on the lookout for signs of internal bleeding or organ rupture, which may not be immediately apparent.
And in penetrating trauma, the location and depth of the injury can inform us about the potential structures involved. Surgical intervention is often necessary, and the golden hour concept is crucial for improving outcomes.
Now, let's discuss sepsis, a condition that can result from infections. It's a complex syndrome where the body's response to infection can lead to tissue damage, organ failure, and death if not recognized and treated promptly.
Early recognition and treatment with antibiotics and fluid resuscitation are essential. The Sepsis 6 bundle provides a framework for this, including blood cultures, lactate measurement, and urine output monitoring.
Before we conclude, I want to emphasize the importance of continuous education in emergency medicine. It's why we create these videos, to share knowledge that can save lives. Ashton, any parting words?
Until next time, stay informed and proactive about your health. And don't forget to subscribe for more insightful discussions on medicine and health.
Oh, and to my viewers, while you're still watching, please help my YouTube channel grow. Remember to like, subscribe, and share. Did you like the video? Please leave a comment below. By the way, should you want to create great cartoon videos like this, start with Polygon Studio, an amazing and easy video tool. Save 10% off with the link in the description below this video. Thanks for watching. Until next time, stay healthy and stay safe. Thanks for watching.